Now, we will consider two resistors, circuits like this. Okay. On the left hand side here, I have three resistances connected in series to a battery, and A is the ammeter over here and K is the key here. Similarly, here on the right side, I have three resistors in parallel, connected in parallel to a battery. Okay, and I have the ammeter over here, and I have three different ammeters connected across and a key over here. So this is the parallel combination of resistors and this is the series combination of resistors. We'll just compare in each case how to go with or how to derive the equivalent resistance of the combination. Okay, now there are three resistances connected over here. As we discussed earlier, the amount of current passing through all the three resistances is the same. So let us assume that it is I. I is the current through the resistance R1, R2 and R3 as well. But what is dividing here is nothing but the potential drops across R1, R2 and R3. Let us assume that V1 is the potential drop across R1. So that means if I have a voltmeter connected over here, the potential drop which it shows is V1. Similarly, V2 is the potential drop across R2. So another voltmeter I will connect across R2. Then I will be able to see what is the value of V2. Similarly, the potential drop across R3, here it is V3, okay, connected across the terminals R3. Now if you see, because the same current is passing through it, but the potential differences are different. If I have a voltmeter which can measure the potential drop across all the three resistors connected like this here, this V will show me the potential difference across all the three resistances connected in series. Now you will observe that V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3. Okay. So the potential drop across all the three resistances put together is equal to the sum of the potential drops across each resistances. Whether I say potential drop or the potential difference, it is the same. So I will get it as V1 plus V2 plus V3. If I sum all the potential differences across each resistor individually, sum of them, I will get the total potential difference across the combination. Now, in case RS is denoting the total resistance of the series combination of the resistances here, then I can write, according to this Ohm's law, I can write V is equal to I into RS. RS is the resistance, total resistance, I can call it as total resistance, or I can call it as net resistance across all the resistances connected in combination. So RS is the net resistance of the combination. Okay, I is the current passing through all the resistances. Now, I can apply the same Ohm's law to each resistance differently. Then I can say, I can write V1 is equal to IR1, V2 is equal to IR2, V3 is equal to IR3. So, for each resistance, I am applying Ohm's law. I am getting the potential difference across R1 as V1 is equal to I into R1, V2 is equal to I into R2, V3 is equal to I into R3. Applying the Ohm's law. Now I substitute for V1, V2, V3 and V in this expression here, then I am going to get it as I into RS is equal to IR1 plus IR2 plus IR3. Right side in all the three, I can take I common over there. Okay, here I have I can cancel out those two. So, if I take I common over here, I will get it as I into R1 plus R2 plus R3 is equal to I into RS. So, this implies that I will get RS is equal to R1 plus R2 plus R3. So this is the expression which shows for the net resistance connected for all the three resistances connected in series. Okay, but when it comes to parallel, the situation is different. What's happening is the current is getting split across the three resistors. So A1, A2, A3 are the three ammeters I have set up in the circuit, and A is the ammeter which is set up for all the three put together. This will show the total amount of current through the circuit, whereas A1, A2, A3 will, these three are paired across each resistance or in combination with each resistance. So A1 will show the current through R1, A2 will show the current through R2, A3 is showing the current through R3. Let us assume that I is the current through all the three, in the total current in the combination. As we discussed, the current is split. I will say I1 is the current through R1, which is indicated in the ammeter A1. Similarly, I say I2 is the current through R2 and shown up in the resistor in the ammeter A2. And similarly here, I3 is the current through the R3, which is shown up in the ammeter A3. The basic expression here what I have is, because the current is split, I can write I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. So just try to observe the major difference between the two types. Here I have V is equal to V1 plus V2 plus V3, whereas here I have I is equal to I1 plus I2 plus I3. Here also I will apply Ohm's law. Okay, according to Ohm's law, I is equal to V by R. Let us assume that V is the total potential difference across all the three. Because they are connected in parallel, the potential difference across all the three resistors is the same as V. Which is the potential difference across the battery? That is this battery over here. Okay. So V will remain the same for each resistor here, whereas V is getting divided in the case of resistors connected in series. Now if I write total current I is equal to V by R, I can apply the same expression. This is according to Ohm's law. I can apply the same expression for each individual resistance. So if I wanted to write for I1, I will get it as V by R1. I2, I will get it as V by R2. I3, I will get it as V by R3. Let us assume that if Rp is representing the total resistance of the combination, they are connected in parallel, Rp is the net resistance of the parallel combination of all the three are connected in parallel. Okay, now I can substitute all these expressions for this, in this expression over here where I is getting divided. Okay, I can write, instead of I will get V by Rp is equal to I1. Instead of I1, I can write V by R1 plus V by R2 plus V by R3. So I can take V common on the expressions, on the terms on the right side here. I can write here it as V into 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is equal to V by Rp. So V and V being common over here can cancel out, resulting in 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So this is the expression for the resistance, net resistance, when two or more resistors are connected in parallel. So one thing you need to observe in both the cases is, whenever the resistances are connected in parallel, the total resistance is, the total resistance is here equal to the sum of all the resistors connected in parallel. That means the net resistance is greater than, the net resistance is greater than any of the resistor connected, any of the biggest resistor connected in the series combination. If I have 10 ohms, 3 ohms, 2 ohms connected in series, then the total resistance what I am going to get is greater than the greatest. If I take 10, 2 and 3, the greatest among the 3 is 10. So if I take the combination, I am going to get 15 ohms, which is greater than the greatest one in the combination. Okay. Similarly, when I go to the parallel combination, if I wanted to tell the same expression in words, in a sentence, I can tell that as the reciprocal of the net resistance in the combination of parallel resistors is equal to the sum of the reciprocals of the individual resistances in the combination, which means that 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. I can extend this expression for any number of resistors connected in parallel. In such a case, what will happen is the total resistance Rp will be less than the least resistance connected in parallel. Suppose I have 3 ohms, 6 ohms and 9 ohms, 3 resistors connected in parallel. Okay, so I will get the net resistance as 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 9. It will be like this. So 1 by 3 plus 1 by 6 plus 1 by 9, this is the net combination 1 by Rp. If I take this, the LCM for all these three is 18. Okay, so I will get here 6 plus 3 plus 1. So it is 10 by 18. What is 1 by Rp? So Rp will be equal to 18 by 10. This is 1.8 ohms. 1.8 is less than the least, that is 3 in the combination. Okay. So the net resistance